Did you know that NASA has finally revealed the truth about the fake moon landings? Mainstream media barely reported on the revelations, so most people remain none the wiser about what NASA has admitted in the last 12 months. The truth of the matter is, NASA has all but admitted the landings were fake, and anybody who works in the space industry or has any knowledge about rocket science has quietly accepted that the whole thing was a charade. So why the hell is nobody talking about this? We literally didn't go to the moon in 1969, and to this day no human being, American, Russian, Chinese, or ancient Egyptian, has been past lower Earth orbit, which is about 1,000 miles above sea level. That's right, no human being has ever been higher than 1,000 miles above sea level. Except for those times we went to the moon, which is 240,000 miles away. And guess what? We did that in 1969, when a computer with the computing power of a TI-89 graphing calculator was the size of a house. Fast forward to today, over 50 years later, when an iPhone has more computing power than every single computer on Earth in 1969 combined. And yet, NASA claims that we can't go back to the moon because we have lost the technology to go to the moon. Apparently, it was destroyed, but they won't tell us how or why.
I'd go to the moon in a nanosecond. The problem is we don't have the technology to do that anymore. We used to, but we destroyed that technology, and it's a painful process to build it back again. But going to Mars should be one of the next series of steps that humans do. The first step should be going back to the moon for a number of technical reasons and exploration reasons, and then after that, Mars, maybe a high orbit in Venus atmosphere, maybe going to Europa. There's all kinds of targets to go to, places of interest in our solar system. The only limit to human future is in our own imagination.
Seems legit, but it gets even worse. Tired of people asking to analyze the original moon landing tapes, NASA had to admit that they lost them. Then the story changed, and they claimed that they had to tape over the original moon landing tapes because of budget cuts.
Here goes Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, step down on the moon, right? One giant step for all of us. Most amazing stories watched by, you know how many people? 600 million people.
And we're getting a picture on the TV.
We all know them. They're blurry. They're really terrible. You look at them and you're like, they're ghosts. You can kind of see through them. And it's why there's controversy about the moon landing in the first place, because people are like, they faked it. Look at it. It's like bad special effects. Thing is, the camera on the lunar module was designed for scientific purposes, not broadcast television. It sent this crystal clear signal to two remote tracking stations in Australia, which fed it through to a small monitor in Sydney, the one in that Polaroid. But to broadcast that signal from Sydney to the rest of the world, it first had to be converted. Here's the great part, is that there's crystal clear, perfect footage of those tapes.
As the grainy signal reached American households and televisions around the world, magnetic tape was capturing that same clear view that the technicians at the tracking stations were seeing on their specially modified screens.
But I'm just an eternal optimist. I'm like a dog with a bone. I won't let go. The very small possibility exists that somebody took those tapes and kept it in his garage or in his attic or wherever.
Apparently, they have since found the original tapes in a suburban garden shed in Las Vegas. Conveniently for NASA, they weren't found in a Hollywood basement used by Stanley Kubrick. And the fact that the TV broadcast watched by hundreds of millions was not sent directly to TV stations, but was rather a projection of the broadcast off a wall, which was then recorded and sent out. Doesn't sound like NASA are covering their tracks or anything. Let's face facts. Everything that was done 50 years ago is 1,000 times cheaper and easier to do today. Are we actually expected to believe that we went to the moon in this piece of shit 50 years ago? I've seen homeless encampments on Skid Row that have more insulation. I've seen Met Gala costumes that look sturdier than that. It's all so implausible. Who shot the event from outside the capsule? How is the American flag waving? Why do the shadows look like they are the result of multiple light sources? Why is the letter C visible on one of the rocks, which happens to look like a prop on a film set? And don't forget about the time NASA astronaut Alan Shepard supposedly sneaked a golf club and some balls onto Apollo 14 and played golf on the moon. Hold on, how do you sneak a golf club onto a spacecraft when every cubic inch and ounce is accounted for? He sneaks it up his arse, obviously. Really, let's think about this rationally. In 1969, we sent a tiny homeless tent covered in aluminium foil 250,000 miles away to a precise location when even being 1/1000th of an inch off in any part of the launch would have caused the ship to miss the moon by thousands of miles. And yet we landed it, we played golf, and now we can't even get humans past 1,000 miles above sea level. Perhaps the final word should go to Buzz Aldrin. According to Buzz, we didn't go to the moon at all. But he didn't stop there. Listen to what he says to the hundreds of millions of people around the world who were affected by the moon landing. It's called mass formation psychosis. The elite have been using this technique to brainwash the masses since 1969.
Okay, Zoe, favorite.
What is your favorite thing about space?
Going there. Going there.
Why has nobody been to the moon in such a long time?
That's not an 8-year-old's question. That's my question. I want to know, but I think I know. Because we didn't go there, and that's the way it happened. And if it didn't happen, it's nice to know why it didn't happen. So in the future, if we want to keep doing something, we need to know why something stopped in the past that we wanted to keep it going.